Hello then, everybody. Welcome to New-NAW. This is your New-NAW owner, Danny Jackpot, along with...
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a voice you probably haven't expected to hear on a New-NAW show. I am Connor Twitty, the voice of WEDF NXT, and one of the many commentators on the main roster of WEDF.
Tonight, we're giving you a special bookmark. New-NAW West Bookmark Edition of the Road to CAWllision 2018. Right now we got Al Cabrera here to defend his NAWVerse Hardcore Championship against Mike Valander in the hardcore match.
Indeed, I don't really know much about Al Cabrera, so I can't really delve into the history of Al Cabrera. I can't really delve into, who trained him and stuff like that as I usually do.
Al Cabrera, from what I hear, he's
kind of an enigma. All I know is that he's done decently well in the best of the super middleweight.
He figures a few wins there.
And,
he won the NAWVerse Hardcore Championship. He started off very well, lost 3 or 4 matches in a row, but bounced back, and now he's doing pretty good. He's been the Ultimate Champion twice. He was due for a title shot on page 24, but Amir Barnes just took him right out. He's able to show off the fact that he is the NAWVerse Hardcore Champion for the first time on NAW programming.
Indeed, and I think Al Cabrera's a promising kid. He has potential, but the thing that's holding him back is his ego. The thing that's holding him back is, he's a little bit self-centered.
I totally agree there, 100%. I've ever talked to Al backstage, this guy's asking you, well, how'd you like his match? How'd you like it? And I don't mind rookies asking that. That's all he wants to talk about. To everybody's, how was their match? Why do you look up at the card, look at the main event, care about that? Because if you don't care about that, then why would we care about what you're doing?
And, my criticism about Al Cabrera is he's too confident in his own ability. He's too confident in himself.
He doesn't ask guys for help.
I don't think he's really done any research on Mike Valander. I don't really think he's done any focus. I think he's just been trying to get himself in a condition where he feels confident he can win this. He can successfully defend the NAWVerse Hardcore Championship. And even then, if he does retain, someone can just swoop in, pin him just like that. I don't think he's ready for the fact that he has to look over his shoulder 24/7.
Now, everyone was asking why TJ Nicholson attacked him. TJ Nicholson went outside. He didn't say it on the TV show, but he went outside on Twitter and he told everybody, man, I'm tired of Al acting this way. Do you know why I attacked him from behind this match? Because it's always me, me, me. Well, guess what? I had to listen to Al one time before I had a match against Mike Valander and I lost. Well, guess what? I made him pay for it later that night. And that's the start of the whole Al and TJ feud.
If he was trained by Jerry Lynn, then you need to do as much research as you can into Mike Valander. Because if you're going to fight a student of Jerry Lynn without any preparation, then you might as well call this lost match.
Now, can I ask you, I'm the new NAW Western Tag Team Champion. I don't have much time to commentate, or look up much facts anymore on these guys, but did you say where did you look up that he was trained from Jerry Lynn? Really?
Indeed he is. Apparently he was trained by the legendary Jerry Lynn, as well as his own father.
That's interesting. I never knew that. Good for Mike Valander. I never knew that.
Well, now they know that where Mike Valander's skills come from. What the hell is Al Cabrera doing?
We're seeing a lot of American whips against the ropes right here. Another American whip! Another big clothesline, but misses!
My God! I guess this guy's really wanted to show his major toe!
Now, I don't know if he was maybe hoping Mike would reverse one of his Irish whips so he could do that, but he eventually got it. I think that's what he was hoping for there.
I think Mike Valander is just showing off. And you can't
What that was. What's it cost him?
I really think he's just showing off. Oh, come on! Ow! No!
Now, Mike Valander started recently wearing pink out here. Oh, good DDT there by Al. But Mike Valander started recently wearing pink out here. The reason why is, well, real men, real tough men wear pink. Watch me go out there and watch a man pink in your ass. Guess what? He goes out there and kicks your ass.
What is he going to bring out from under the ring? And he brings out, oh, I don't know. I think that's a baseball bat. I think he got a baseball bat from under that ring.
Well, hardcore match should be legal for this NAWVerse Hardcore Championship. And the referee is far away from the count right there. Anyone notice that? Trained. The independent training facility, is that correct? The independent training facility, ITF. He didn't just come from there. He also came from, he worked death matches on the independent before he met up with us. And he, all these scars on his body, he hates to tell the story. He wants you to believe that a slave owner whipped him at one point in his life. But really, he used to wrestle with these hardcore gruesome matches and they tore up his body. And now that he's found a home, you know, he doesn't have to kill himself here anymore. But the Nuevo Conquistqadors, a former Western Tag Team Champion, they have to lose the titles to who, Connor? We have to lose the Tag Team titles to Connor.
And,
the plus line.
So, Amir
Barnes. Jackpot and Zach Starr.
They're very impressive team to take the titles from.
The Nuevo Conquistqadors, they defeated Damage Ace for the Western Tag Titles, and they defeated him in a water match rematch. These little guys can go. I promise you, these little two guys can go. Cowboys and a gimmick, this is me. I'm Butch Simpson.
And I don't think a lot of people
West Coast champion, should be the West Coast champion. They had a rematch at CAWllision coming up in a last man standing match. Steven Raden emptied the cheap shot, the disqualification, the low blow, retained his championship on page 28. It was disgusting. It was terrible. It was exactly what I'd like to see and exactly what I would do if I was him in that situation. Steven Raden, I could not be no longer more proud of, but I am.
Danny. Come on, Danny. That was absolutely inexcusable backstab by Steven Raden.
He's the perfect example of, I love the fans, I'll do anything for him. I have the world title. What do you mean I'm gonna lose it? What do you mean I'm done? What do you mean a low blow and I take it home with me? Steven Raden is a perfect example of that, but right now coming to the ring is Mason Kronik, one of the newest signees of NAW, and I am proud to say we have this guy as a member of this roster. Big, strong, dominant, Mason Kronik. He is here to make an impact, and I promise you, in a very short time, this guy will make an impact here in New-NAW.
Yeah, Mason Kronik.
Just debuted here 2 episodes ago on page 26. Him and Amir teamed up, destroyed Suspect, and I think it was Alex Stryker, destroyed him, didn't even make it, made him worth something on the next page himself. Mason Kronik, once again, destroying the competition. Mike Valander, who we just seen with the NAWVerse Hardcore title, who was picking up win after win. Mason Kronik squashed him. Mason Kronik is the real deal here in New-NAW. And his tag team partner, the West Coast champion, if he gets past Larry at CAWllision, Mason Kronik is probably with the very next threat at his belt. And look at the new look on Steven Raden, though. Look at this new look. Dyed hair, gray attire. This new attitude. I don't like it. I like it, though, but I don't. Who do you think you are, Steven Raden, to have this attitude? Who do you ever be?
Steven Raden. Absolutely disgusted by himself. Larry trusted him. Larry considered him a friend. And yet he does that. This is exactly what winning a piece of championship gold can do to a man.
Now he knows where Andrew Leanna feels like.
Oh, yeah.
Butch Simpson immediately taking it to Mason Kronik right away. What a match. Oh my god. Butch Simpson, they need to call Firecracker Butch Simpson because he is a firecracker. You don't expect this guy to just come at you like he does.
Absolutely nothing is being held back by Butch Simpson.
Well, firecracker Butch Simpson. That's
no! Me.
I gotta say, I'm pretty sure this is the very first time we've ever seen Butch Simpson and Mason Kronik in the very same ring. Let alone Mason Kronik and Larry in the same ring.
And it's an honor to call that historic moment.
I mean, look at the match that Mason Kronik had got himself into in his very first match, or his third match. He's teaming up with West Coast champion. And it's what he's going to do. Big back elbow right there between the two of them. But miscommunication right there is Mason Kronik almost had a hard time getting out of the ring.
Yeah, trying to find his way around the two battling. Now, what would be the strategy for Steven Raden here tonight? What would be his strategy?
The strategy for Steven Raden would be not getting in the ring with Lariat. You don't want Lariat to get any more momentum going into CAWllision, and Lariat definitely has momentum in this match. If Mason Kronik and Steven Raden can just pick up a win against Butch, keep him isolated from Lariat, pick up a victory, that would help him get some momentum and stop that fright train that is Lariat right now.
Oh, indeed, and he went for the pin. I think he was more so trying to wear out Butch Simpson than actually get the win. Oh no!
And CAWllision comes early once again, boys.
Here we go! Larry is going aggressive on his former friend, on the man who stabbed him right in the back, who took that knife.
Came the got nailed with Lariat, with the Lariat, and he got up.
Couldn't end Mason Kronik, not even a Larry. Not even that close.
West Brand.